Hey guys, hope you all are doing well. I just want to leave you with a quick message, and I want to talk about how we need God's grace and truth, because we know that Jesus Christ came to bring us grace and truth. It says that he was full of grace and truth in the book of John. And so I'm going to kick it off with a verse that I think has really been a blessing, that has always reminded me of this combination of mercy and grace with truth, and that is Psalm 85 verse 10. It says, mercy and truth are met together, righteousness and peace have kissed each other. And I think this verse is a great reminder for us that Jesus Christ comes in truth. We know that it says that he is the way, the truth, and the life, so we can't negate the fact that the aspect of God that we can never disconnect from is that he is truth, he is the way, the truth, and the life. But we see in the book of John, we see in John 1 verse 14, and the word was made flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. So one inseparable aspect of Jesus Christ that we can never negate is that he is truth, the way, the truth, and the life, but he is also full of grace as well as truth. And when we are reminded of God's grace, it says that in Ephesians, I believe it's 2 verse 8, it says, for by grace we are saved through faith. It is that grace, it is by his grace that we are able to be saved through placing our faith in Jesus Christ. And it is not of ourselves, it is the gift of God. It refers to that segment, for by grace we are saved through faith, as the gift of God, not of works, lest any man should boast, or so that no man can boast. So it is not of our doing, but it is through the grace of God. What I love is he said, mercy and truth are met together. On one end, we are sinners. We are sinners. All have sinned and come short of the glory. Yet, there is grace and mercy. And so you have grace meeting up with truth, and that is where the grace of God comes into place. We are saved by his grace. We're not saved by our works, although that doesn't negate the fact that if we have authentic faith, then there will be works that accompany it, because faith without works is dead. But because of God's grace, and that he is filled with grace and truth, we can walk knowing that we have his grace. And I was just so blessed going back to 1 Corinthians chapter 15 and reading where Apostle Paul talks about the gospel with the church of Corinth, and he basically goes through the death, burial, and resurrection and talks about all the people Jesus came in contact with. And I found it amazing how Jesus, he had an experience with Jesus, even though Jesus had ascended. In verse 8 of 1 Corinthians 15, it says, and last of all, he was seen of me also. Apostle Paul was the last man to see Jesus in the flesh. And it says, as of one born out of time. And it goes on to say, for I am the least of the apostles, that I am not met or meet to be called an apostle, because I persecuted the church of God. So he calls himself the least of the apostles. But God's grace, but by the grace of God, I am what I am. And his grace, which was bestowed upon me, was not in vain, but I labored more abundantly than they all, yet not I, but the grace of God, which was with me. So God's grace was with Apostle Paul in that he did terrible things to the church of God, but by God's grace, he was saved through placing his faith in Jesus. By his grace, and it wasn't of works, it was not of any manifestation of works, but because of the grace of God, his grace led him to faith that allowed him to do the works that God was calling for him to do. And we all, if you've read the passage in the book of Acts when Apostle Paul came to Christ, that faith that came as a result of God's grace led to Apostle Paul doing great works. And that's why he said he labored more abundantly because of the grace that was over his life, because it was the grace. And it wasn't his works. It was all the grace of God that was with him that allowed for him to do the things that he was able to do. And so I just want to encourage you. The purpose of this message is to encourage you to lean on the grace of God. It says in 2 Corinthians chapter 12, my grace is sufficient for thee. Jesus said this, for my strength is made perfect in weakness. So we must glory in the fact that we have God's grace with us, which is sufficient to carry us. And The same God that brought us to all the different things, trials, tribulations, struggles, everything that we go through, the same God that has brought us to those things is going to be the one to carry us through by both his grace and truth. So let us be filled with grace and truth, and let us continue in the love of God.